This tutorial shows the calculation of effect sizes for post-hoc tests with sufficiently low p-values after a Friedman test in SPSS. Unfortunately, SPSS does not calculate an effect size for you. However, to calculate the effect size R, a simple division is sufficient. For the effect size R, you need to divide the absolute value of the standardized test statistic Z by the square root of the number of observations. Both numbers are provided within the output of the Friedman test. Total N is the number of paired observations and can be found at the top of the test summary table. Please note that some sources will not use the number of pairs for n, but rather the number of pairs times 2. Whatever you favor, I would advise reporting that accordingly. When we look closely in the pairwise comparisons table, you can spot the standardized test statistic for each comparison, regardless of the p-value. I have two pairwise comparisons with sufficiently low p-values after adjusting for alpha error inflation. T1 and T2 show a standardized test statistic Z of -3.834. And T1 and T3 show a Z value of -4.93. Both will be divided by the square root of 60. I can either do that in Excel, Google Sheets, or use the calculator. If you want the calculation to be as exact as possible, I would recommend using Excel or Google Sheets and copy the standardized test statistic with all decimals available and do the calculation there. The resulting effect sizes R have values of 0.495 and 0.636, rounded to 3 decimals. Finally, you need to classify the magnitude of those effects. If similar studies in your research field exist, compare your effect sizes with the given one. Ideally, those studies also discuss the choice of N. If no comparable study exists, use the common thresholds within your research field. If those are also non-existent, you can refer to Cohen 92, a power primer. Page 157 shows 3 thresholds for the effect size R, 0.1, 0.3 and 0.5 for small, medium and large effects. In my example, I have basically 2 large effects and if I use Cohen's thresholds. If I use the number of pairs times 2 for n, my effect sizes will be 0.35 and 0.45 accordingly. When you're done, you have to write up the results. The video that appears now will show you how.